It's time again for the Science Bowl.
Zoo parade for five. What big teeth the hippo has are actually a pair of these. Science potpourri for 10. Would a snake most likely eat every day? Every week, Dateline Science for 10. Why are some elephants wearing necklaces these days? Green things for 15.
And now, here's your host, Mr. Z himself, Dave Zarin.
Thank you, and welcome to the Science Bowl, the science quiz program here in the Prince George's Schools, where we test scientific literacy. Test your own and play along with us today. Let's meet today's teams. First, from Brandywine Elementary School, would you please say hello to Nicholas Coleman, Emma Davis, and Kendall Wicks. And from CMIT, Chesapeake Math and Information Technology, would you say hello, please, to Xavion Giles, Jonathan Pinnell, and Talawani Akinsola. And now here are the categories of questions we use on the Science Bowl.
Okay, Mr. Z, here's today's categories. Green things, questions about plants and all things green and growing. Zoo parade, a Noah's Ark of questions about animals. Body systems, we'll see how much you know about yourself, about things like breathing and growing and digesting your food. Let's get physical. Questions that test your knowledge of physics and chemistry, earth science and space science. Then there's science potpourri. Here's a grab bag of science questions, everything from air pollution to the kitchen sink. And finally, Dateline Science. We'll ask you about science history and science in the news.
Here on the Science Bowl, we arrange our game board according to question difficulty, with the easier questions on the left worth 5 and 10, tougher ones worth 15, 20, and ultimately 25, the toughest of them all. Both of our teams start out at 50 points. No penalties ever for incorrect answers. End of the two rounds today, one of these talented, good-looking teams will come back to play Woodridge for the chance to move on to take on University Park in the semifinals in this year's elementary competition. Let's make sure everything works properly before we start. Let's go to the red team, and Emma, would you try that buzzer? Looks and sounds good. Good luck to you, to Nick, and to Kendall. Jonathan, give her a push. All right, A-OK over there with the green team, Jonathan, Talawani, and Xavion. Are we ready? All right, let's do this. Let's have a good time. B before C, so Brandywine and Emma, let's play the bowl.
Zoo parade for five.
Zoo parade for 5 points. Teams, when the water came down the water spout, this itsy-bitsy arachnid, Emma?
Spider.
The spider got washed right out, absolutely right. And tried it again after that sun dried up all the rain. Go red.
Let's get physical for five.
Let's get physical for 5 points. Teams, Proxima Centauri, which is the closest star to Earth other than the sun, is 4.2 of these units away from us. CMIT.
Metric?
Not metric, no. What units are used for measuring distance in the solar system? 4.2 what?
Light years.
Light years, that's exactly right. Thank you, Nick, good answer. Go, Emma.
Green things for 10.
Green things for 10 points. Listen, this is interesting. The most consumed, eaten seed in America is this same one that Alibaba used to open the cave to get the 40 thieves to come out. Open what? CMIT.
Apple seed.
Not apple seed, no. Brandywine.
Sesame.
Open sesame. And you know why we eat so many of them? Because that's what McDonald's puts on their buns. All right, go red.
Body systems for five.
Body systems for 5 points. Teams, the Venus de Milo has no arms. The horseman in Sleepy Hollow had no head. And on Sesame Street, Elmo is an edentate because he has no what? Brandywine?
Teeth.
He has no teeth. The poor guy's got to gum all his food. Okay, go red.
Green things for five.
Green things for 5 points. Teams, even though there are no knives in your front lawn, each leaf of grass is called one of these. A blade. Blades of grass. Try again, red.
Science potpourri for five.
Potpourri for 5 points. Teams, when a rabbit is scared and is trying to act invisible like a predator isn't there, it freezes. Just like human beings today are doing this challenge where they freeze in place, Brandywine.
Mannequin challenge.
Yeah, that rabbit's doing a mannequin challenge there, hoping the fox doesn't see it. Good. Red.
Body systems for 10.
Body systems for 10 points. Teams, your body's inferior and superior vena cavae are these kinds of blood vessels. They are veins. Veins. Vena cavae was your clue. Go red.
Let's get physical for 15.
Get physical for 15 points. Two-part answer. The Swedish scientist Anders Celsius came up with the Celsius or centigrade scale, meaning that water froze at what temperature and boiled at what temperature? What is the range on the Celsius scale? From what to what? Water freezes at 0 and it boils at 100. On the Fahrenheit scale, it's 32 versus 212. Go again, red.
Super 8 for 10.
Super 8 for 10 points. Teams, this animal breathes in on the he and out on the ha. Hee-haw. Green.
Donkey.
Yeah, donkey. All right. Go. CMIT.
Body systems for 15.
For 15 points, teams, diabetes affects a person's eyes, feet, and these renal organs. Brandywine.
Your pancreas?
Not your pancreas, good try. Diabetes affects primarily your eyes, your feet, and these renal organs.
Heart?
Your kidneys. Your kidneys are the renal organs. Try again, green. Jonathan?
Let's get physical for 10.
Get physical for 10 points. Teams, there are very few English words that have two U's side by side. One of them is this, which is a space with nothing in it. Brandywine.
Vacuum.
Yes, ma'am. Nicely done. Red.
Green things for 15.
Green things for 15 points. Teams, your question is as follows. Wild cherry syrup, which is used as a cough medication, comes from this tough outer covering on the trunk of the cherry tree. The bark is the tough outer covering. Go again, red.
Super 8 for 15.
Super 8 for 15 points is a visual question. Look at the monitor in the studio, please. In Africa, fast food is not a McDonald's hamburger. Rather, it is one of these big, juicy maggots. Maggots are what stage in the metamorphic development of an insect? Brandywine.
Pupa.
Not pupa. Good try. CMIT. It's the larva. The larval stage is the maggot. All right, we've come to the end of our first round here. Our score right now is CMIT 60, Brandywine 90. We'll be back with some interviews with our young people and more Science Bowl in just a moment. Don't go away. Welcome back to Science Bowl. So nice to have you here today. Thank you for spending time with us. This is our 31st year doing Science Bowl here in the Prince George's County Public Schools, and we always enjoy the new students coming to play our game, and we've got six of them here today, six outstanding young people. Let's meet them. First from Brandywine Elementary. Emma, nice to have you with us here today. Tell us about your school. Who is your principal?
Miss Lee.
Miss Lee, and I know she's out there supporting you. And who's the sponsor of your team?
Mrs. Losey.
Yes, indeed. And Gina, thank you for all you do over the years here. And you always like to give all of your students an opportunity to play here. And it's great to have had you through many of our 31 years here. Brandywine, always a great contender. Tell us any alternates on your team.
We have Tyler Phillips, Anaya Paul, and Joshua Price.
Wow, so you got like a shadow team out there. All right, so we'll meet them in a few moments with Miss Losey. Always like to ask schools about what they brag about. What is it about Brandywine you say, wow, this is the best?
The teachers make learning fun.
Yeah, and if it's not fun, why bother, right? Yeah, I mean, if you're in there and they can make learning something that you really want to do each and every day, then you're in the right place. What do you want to do someday, Emma?
When I grow up, I want to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah, and you already have a business, and I chided at her earlier because when she told me what it was, and she's about to tell you, she didn't bring any samples. Emma, what do you do?
I'm a pastry and a candy seller.
Yeah, I mean, I tasted those cupcakes, but you know, that's just gonna have to imagine it. You have a good head on your shoulders. I can imagine you're gonna be a good businesswoman. Nice to have you back. Kendall, nice to have you here with us today. Tell us what you do in your spare time.
On my spare time, I like to sew and read.
Yeah, because you are interested in interior design, right?
Yes.
So what do you imagine? You're going to do hotels or resorts or houses. What do you think yourself, what you'll be doing later on?
I think I might want to design houses.
Houses, yeah. In fact, here in the school system, we have a student-built house project where some of the high school students, they go to this house and they design everything inside. I hope you get to be part of that, Kendall. You'd be good at that. Nicholas, you've been giving Emma some good advice here. How do you know so much science?
Well, I just like watch the science bowls and get some answers. Yeah. And Miss Losi, she helps us out in some.
She's a very good coach, and you obviously are a very good listener, and because you've absorbed a lot of material here. What do you see yourself doing someday?
I see myself maybe engineering and making things.
Yeah, because you told me you want to invent something, right? And I asked him, what do you want to invent? And he said, that's company secret, Mr. Z. You know, he doesn't want to give away his copyright here, his trademark. I understand that. All right, we'll keep your eye on you, Nick. Nice to have you with us. CMIT, nice to have you. First time ever on our show. A school that's only 3 years old. That's what Ms. McCain was telling me. Jonathan, tell us who your principal is.
Miss Riley.
Miss Riley, yes. And sorry she couldn't be here today, but I know she's backing you. And who's your sponsor?
Our sponsor is Miss McCain, but when we're at school, our club teachers are Miss Cooper and Miss Ahmed.
Wonderful. We thank everybody who was involved to get you here because, like I say, first time ever. Nice to have you with us. Any alternates on your team?
Yes, Corey Wickfall and Stanislaus Victor.
Wonderful. And I met them before, and they have the same white shirts. Is that your uniform you're wearing? You guys look very sharp today, and we'll bring them out along with Miss McCain in a few moments here. Best thing about the school? What do you like about it?
I like the Lego engineering, the technology. I love the math and science because math is like really fun. And then science, I love how we get to do like a whole bunch of experiments and then field trips and different things we get to do in our school.
Well, I can hear the excitement in your voice. You're a good spokesperson for CMIT. And you want to get involved in Legos professionally someday, right? And you also are interested in chemistry and archery. And what am I leaving out?
Lawyer.
All right. So you're going to wear a lot of different hats. I know you can handle that. Good team over there, but let's see you get some more points in the second half. All right? All right. Xavion, nice to have you here. You're a basketball player, yeah?
Well, I play basketball.
You play basketball. Well, he's not being too cocky about this. What do you see yourself doing professionally someday?
Video game designing and being a basketball player once I retire. Yeah. I'm going to be a video game designer.
Wonderful. All right, so you got it all planned out, right?
Yes.
Yeah. What do you do in your spare time if you're not playing video games or playing basketball? You watch YouTube?
Yes, most of the time I watch the science bowl because I like to see how different students answer their questions and the clues you put in the questions.
Boy, you're a very good student of the game because I too try to give clues and everything, and I see your eyes lighting up when I give those clues. You're a good player. Talawani, nice to have you with us today. Tell us the Talawani story. What do you want to do someday?
I want to be many things. But my most two priorities I want to be is a soccer player and an actor.
Wow. I like the use of your word priorities. You're a really mature young man. I can see you as an actor. You've got stage presence. Have you done any acting as yet?
No. I have not.
That's all right. I haven't. You know, every day in life you have to act things out in certain ways. I bet you've been honing your craft. Anyhow, nice to have you with us today. Let's get back to our game. CMIT 60-90 for Brandywine. Lots of points to give away. Emma, you gave us the last correct answer, so you get to start us out in round two. Go ahead.
Dateline Science for 5.
Dateline Science for 5 points. Teams, the Lowell Observatory in Flagstaff, Arizona is where this former planet was first discovered. CMIT.
Venus?
Not Venus, nope. This former planet was first discovered at the Lowell Observatory in Flagstaff.
Pluto,
yeah. We're all sorry that it got kicked out of the club. All right. Red, go.
Science potpourri for 15.
Potpourri for 15 points. Teams, this carbonized plant material, which is combustible, comes in anthracite and bituminous varieties. What fossil fuel am I talking about? CMIT.
Chloroplast.
Not chloroplast, no. What you think? Brandywine, this combustible carbonized plant material is what kind of fossil fuel? Coal. Go red. What Santa brings to bad boys and girls. Okay, go red.
Dateline Science for 15.
Dateline for 15 points. All right, teams, there's a new book out called Hidden Figures. It's all about the African-American women, mathematicians, who were hired during World War II by this space agency. CMIT.
NASA,
yeah. NASA, CMIT, got it. Good. Green.
Dateline Science for 25.
Dateline for 25 points. Teams, the Nobel Prize in Physiology in 1923 went to a man called Frederick Banting because he was the first person to discover this hormone produced by the pancreas that diabetics need. Name that hormone for 25 points. Red.
Insulin.
Yes, ma'am. Nicely done. Thank you, Kendall, for your assist. Go.
Green things for 20.
Green things, 20 points. Teams, a plant that dies back in the winter to the ground, but whose roots live on year after year after year, is known as this kind of plant. It keeps coming back. It's a perennial as opposed to an annual plant that dies out like a geranium. Go red.
Let's get physical for 20.
Physical for 20 points. Multiple choice question. Teams, if you go to Las Vegas, you shouldn't go, you can't gamble yet, but if you go to sightsee, the tallest hotel in Las Vegas is named for this second layer. I will give you some choices. The second layer of the atmosphere above the Earth. Is it called the ionosphere hotel, the troposphere hotel, or the stratosphere hotel? Which one, Brandywine?
The stratosphere.
That's exactly right. The stratosphere, a well-known icon on the Vegas skyline. Red.
Super 8 for 25.
Super 8 for 25. Big one in that category. Teams, even if your house is very clean, it's bugged. There are over 600 genuses of these A-initialed phylum creatures. CMIT.
Ants?
No, not eggs. What A-initialed phylum do all of these bugs belong to?
Ants?
Arthropods. Arthropods for 25 points. I'm not going to give you 25 points for the answer ants. No, you need the big word. Okay, go again, Red.
Body systems for 20.
Body systems for 20 points. Teams, these E-initialed chemicals in your body help to digest your food, but they themselves are not used up in the process. Those are enzymes. Try again, Red.
Science potpourri for 10.
Potpourri for 10 points. Teams, maybe you heard about this on the news. This softest of minerals that is found in baby powder is now suspected of maybe causing cancer.
What?
Brandywine.
May I pass it to Kendall, please?
Surely.
Talcum powder?
Yes, ma'am. Talc it is. Nicely done. She was a little hesitant there, but she knows her stuff. Go, Red.
Dateline Science for 10.
Dateline for 10 points. This is very disturbing. The chemical that a man said he used to cure autism turned out to be this chlorinated stuff that you use to make your clothes white. CMIT.
Dye?
Not dye. Brandywine.
Bleach.
Bleach. He said if you drank bleach, it would cure autism. Thank goodness there were no trials and nobody was injured in that. Go, Red.
Green things for 25.
Green things for 25 points. Listen carefully. Let's see how good your vocabulary is. We all know that plants need water, but too much water on a plant's leaf can cause bacteria to grow there. So you see water on a plant leaf beading up because leaves are not hydrophilic. They don't love water. They are hydro what? The opposite of hydrophilic is hydrophobic. Go again, Red.
Body systems for 25.
Body systems for 25. A visual question. Look at the monitor for this question. Teams, people who get a hip replaced would have this kind of x-ray. You're looking at the hip and you can see on the left and the right, on the bottom corners there, the top of the femur bones, and where you see the red is what kind of joint? What kind of joint is that for 25 points, CMIT?
Tibia.
Not a tibia, no. What kind of joint do you think that is, Brandywine? It's a ball and socket joint. You see the ball, you see the socket? That's where it is. You get a new one of those. Try again, Rid. Let's go.
Science potpourri for 20.
Potpourri for 20 points. Teams, you heard this in the news. People who traveled to East Africa to see the wildlife, they weren't going anymore because they heard about this virus, which wasn't in East Africa. Emma?
Zika.
Not Zika. No, this virus was all in West Africa, Ebola. Not East Africa, CMIT.
Ebola.
Ebola it is. Yeah, absolutely. Good. Okay, Green, go.
Dateline Science for 20.
Dateline Science for 20 points. Teams, the last time the Chicago Cubs won the World Series, sliced bread hadn't even been invented, and this man, Xavion, who invented the incandescent light bulb, was still alive. Brandywine?
Thomas Edison.
That's right. Good. Red.
Let's get physical for 25.
Physical for 25 points. Back in 1957, the USSR, Russia, launched this spacecraft that launched the space race between Russia and the United States. Can you name it? That was called Sputnik. Go, Red.
Zuprade for 20.
Zuprade for 20 points. Teams, Jane Goodall will never win a Nobel Prize because there is no Nobel Prize for zoology, even though she did lots of animal behavior studies on this animal. Jane Goodall and this animal, CMIT.
Monkey.
More specifically.
Gorilla.
Not gorilla. No, Brandywine. What specific animals did Jane Goodall study in her animal behavior studies?
A chimpanzee.
Chimpanzee is absolutely right. Last question of the game is Super Science Potpourri for 25 points. Here it is. Astronauts on the International Space Station can look down and they can see the Great Wall of China that we people built. They can also see this great thing that Mother Nature built. What can they see? The Great Barrier Reef off the coast of Australia. That's the end of our game. We'll be back with a wrap-up in just a moment. Don't go away. Welcome back, everybody. Good day here on Science Bowl. Even though CMIT was here for the first time, they did very well. We're proud of them, and we're proud of Brandywine. Our final tally is CMIT 95, Brandywine 200. Congratulations, Nicholas and Emma. She does smile. And Kendall. And look at the shadow team back there. We've got Tyler and Anaya and Joshua and Miss Losey. Congratulations. We're going to see you against Woodridge. And Zavon, let me see a nice big smile over there. Did a nice job here today. Jonathan, super job here. Talawani, great to have you here, our future actor, right? All right, and we've got Stanislaus and Corey back there, and thank you, Ms. McCain, for all you did to get these students here this time, and we hope to see you in the future. We'll see you next time. I'm Dave Zarin. Bye-bye now.